Previously on Audrina. I booked my first feature with Marie Claire.
We would love you to be in our dress code section.
Oh my God, thank you so much.
My boyfriend Corey wasn't too happy about my career coming before him.
Can't you like cancel some stuff?
I can't cancel it.
And our family dinner turned into World War III.
Stop.
The way you're acting right now, you will never see them.
So right now, I'm a maniac. I'm emotional and upset, and I'm done with them.
Audrina takes my mom's side. Regardless of anything that happens, it's always been like that. I'm sorry. I'm just over it.
I have to go. I'm doing this skit for Funny or Die.
Get your day done and get home. How's that sound?
Oh, whatever.
How's it going with Corey?
I took his phone and I found naked pictures of girls on it.
To shoot a feature for Marie Claire magazine called Dress Code, and basically it's the day in the life of Audrina.
Hi, how are you?
How are you?
Good.
Welcome.
Good to see you again.
This is my first big magazine feature, so I'm super excited. After this photo shoot, I'm heading back to LA because Corey is coming back from Australia. Corey had been gone a couple weeks, and even though I was working a lot and my mind and time was consumed, I missed him and I couldn't wait to see him.
It's time to get some clothes.
Okay, right. Let's do it.
Hop on in there. Go to your little tea.
Well, let's go for some kick.
Wow, that was a kick.
Great, and spin around.
Really pretty.
I'm trying to take my career in a new direction toward fashion. And I think this photo shoot is really going to give me the opportunity to show people a different side of me.
Looks great. Audrina is going to look brilliant in the pages of Marie Claire. She's exactly the kind of girl we love. She's young, she's energetic, she's smart. It was fun to kind of give her a little bit of a transformation.
When I'm doing business trips, Corey texts me all the time, and I was like, oh my God, here it goes again, just because I can't respond back to every single message right away. I'm not there to socialize and go flirt.
Okay, next look.
Looking down. I like that. Take it all the way off. Go ahead and tie it, yeah.
Maybe the collar, maybe a bit.
Yeah, bring it one end out, yeah. And go for it again, yeah.
Nice.
It was a great experience. And it's going to be in the June issue, which is summertime, so it's awesome. Having a boyfriend in Australia is actually really hard because I've never dealt with this long-distance relationship thing, and I miss him. I was so excited to go pick him up at the airport.
How you going, babe?
How you going?
Good, how are you?
I'm good.
God, it's so good to see you. Did you get that back door? I'll chuck it in the back seat.
Hey, how's everyone doing, Ella?
There's a little bit of drama going on.
Between you and...
my sister, Casey.
Yeah, I don't even want to get into it. Let's just spend some time together. I just want to kick off the shoes and chill. Like, I don't want to be out and about, you know?
Yeah.
I have to go. I'm doing this skit for Funny or Die. When I told him that I had to go to the shoot, he didn't really like that.
We can't even get home, and you're going to go and do something right now?
It's only for a couple hours, Corey.
I just got off the plane, and I have to leave you already.
It's really important to me.
I suppose, hey, you know.
So, do you think you can drop me off, and then maybe we can go to dinner later?
I don't know what the f*** is going on. Get your day done and get home. How's that sound?
Oh, whatever. This is my job. I don't think it's right that I should constantly be worried about Corey and his feelings because he should be supportive and excited for me.
All right, I'll call you when I'm almost done.
All right, well, in a couple hours, I'll get you.
For Funny or Die, I was playing a scientist who is super smart, and I've been working on this new rocket engine to send off into space, and it's based in total reality. Rocketdyne is a place where they actually make real rocket engines, and this place is pretty hardcore.
To actually clean out the inside of our ducts. It's all computer generated so that we can tell when to flush it and then we dry it all in one setup. We have a 5-axis mill if you want to say something about that. A Mazak turn mill.
Mazak,
M-A-Z-A-K turn mill.
You have to be really smart to work here.
Do you want to run it?
Yeah. Well, when I was a kid, I actually really liked model rockets.
Model rockets?
Yeah, right? I just thought, oh, let me just read through this.
Sure.
I just thought they were cool. I had just seen Corey, and he knew that I had to memorize my lines and kind of get into character and just clear my head. And he just kept calling, and I could just hear my phone buzzing. I can't focus. I can't concentrate. And he does it to me all the time. I hate it.
Scene 2, take 1. Marker.
Cool. And action.
Well, when I wasn't shooting all the time, I actually wanted to use that time by being productive, which led to me studying more, working towards my degree.
So how, Audrina, did you know this was your calling? This is something that you wanted to do.
This is the place that made the Apollo and Atlas engines. I'm a huge fan of Funny or Die, and I would love to work with them again, but Corey had been calling and texting me relentlessly and almost like he was attacking me. I can't concentrate. It's like a cycle, and I'm sick of it. This is my life, and I'm not going to change it just because he's unhappy with it. And at this point, I just feel like I have to pick and choose my either career or relationship.
Take your breath and shoot.
Calm down, Lynn.
How's it going with Corey?
He wants me to delete my Facebook. He's really protective.
Protective or jealous?
But I love Drina so much, and I'm not going anywhere.
Hi, welcome to Evans Gunsmithing.
Howdy.
Hi.
Guys here to shoot?
I'm Mark Patridge. How you doing?
I'm Skipper.
I decided to take my family to the gun range because my father and my grandfather and my uncles, we always went hunting, and I just wanted to share that experience with my kids, and they will continue that on maybe to their kids.
What we're going
to
do today is we're going to go out on the range and actually shoot, so. Yeah. Who wants to be first?
I'll go. I've never shot a gun before in my life, so I was a little nervous, and I did not wear the proper footwear.
Right, okay, safety off. Take your breath. And shoot. Dead center. Okay.
Well, I felt like, wow, like it's almost intimidating. This little gun has so much power in it.
I love the smell. Smell of firearm.
Okay, who's next?
Badass.
Any questions?
No.
Remember, front sight in focus. And you view it right through this little notch. Hang on, finger off the trigger. Wait until I tell you to.
Oh, my bad.
Okay, squeeze slowly.
Wow.
Awesome, Sam. You're bad.
She's doing very well. She's the best so far. Pick your weapon up, finger off the trigger. Nice and firm, but okay, you're kind of caressing. Safety's right here. Pull all the way down. No, pull. There you go. Don't point your weapon up. Finger on the trigger and squeeze slowly.
How can you miss it?
Do it again.
You're like, are you kidding me? What the heck was that?